Morbius trailer, breakdown and analysis. Recently, the second trailer of Morbius was released, and it has shocked all the audience by the details it reveals in the trailer. Since the release, it has been making rounds on Twitter, and so many astonishing details come forth because we all know that Marvel and shocking trailers go hand in hand, right? So let us walk you through the trailer of this amazing Marvel movie and spill the tea of what it actually is about, and trust us, you will be amazed. This new MCU movie seems pretty dark and bloody by the looks of it, and since its second trailer has been released, it is all over the internet because of so many reasons. Fans are quite divided in their opinion, and some of them are totally loving this new approach, while others are not into it. In the trailer, we will see the supervillain of Spider-Man Morbius in action, and he is the main character in this movie, so you can expect a lot of exciting things and a lot of bloody things as well, because Morbius, after all, is a living vampire. The trailer starts with the origin story of how Morbius actually became the supervillain, and it turns out that he was not always been the blood-sucking creature that we have seen him be. In fact, he was a scientist who was working for the welfare of people. Sadly, Morbius is affected by a deadly plague and he is working to find the cure. And what he does for it is pretty interesting. In one scene of the trailer, Morbius is even seen taking care of children, so all in all, he does not really seem a person who would mean any harm to other people. But he somehow finds out that he is going to discover the cure in the bats, so he goes to a cave and exposes a wound. This way, bats can be attracted towards him, and after this rekindling with bats, you'll be shocked to know what happens next. In the trailer, the next scene you would see is where Morbius is now having enormous power, including speed and strength, and the graphics in those scenes are beyond perfect, along with the overall dim lighting in the scene that makes it much more realistic and scarier, to be honest. But in the process of curing himself with the help of bats, he literally becomes a creature thirsty for blood, with powers that are unmatched and not some random superhero powers, but really unique ones like echolocation, speed, and strength. Certain scenes in the trailer show not only his powers but also his urge to drink human blood, and that is when we realize that instead of curing himself, he has turned himself into a new and dangerous type of monster that has to be stopped. Now, the trailer does not disclose everything about the main plot, but it does give us an idea about the origin of Morbius and exactly what is the central idea of the movie, but we still need to figure out that at what point this movie connects to the Spider-Man movie. You'll be really shocked to know that in one scene at the trailer, a Spider-Man's picture is on the wall and someone has written "murderer" in graffiti over the photo. This reminds us of the time in Far From Home when everyone thought that Spider-Man himself was the murderer. Also, the image of Spider-Man basically is taken from a PS4 game from 2018, and as if things were not already confusing enough, we now have to link the dots and figure out where exactly would Morbius' story be connected to Spider-Man. It is really exciting that the beast mode of Morbius is inspired a lot by the comics, and the bloody red eyes, long and pointy teeth with longer hair are just having all the Halloween vibes that we need. The graphics of this scene should also be appreciated, as they make the scene far scarier than it already is. As the trailer does not have a lot of glimpses of his beast mode, critics are wondering whether we would see it in the movie a lot or not. People really want to see Morbius in full action, so it would be great if more of him come all beastie on screen often. Though the trailer is quite confusing because we have to keep wondering till the very end about what universe are we exactly in, the confusion is further multiplied by 100 when Michael Keaton appears at the end of the trailer. He was last spotted in Spider-Man Homecoming, so we really are puzzled about what the makers really want to do with the cinematic universe. Also, critics are pointing out that Marvel and Sony are deliberately swapping characters, and in this trailer, all the hints about different universes are intentionally given, so people wonder and get curious, which would be really helpful for the movie in the long run. Well, we don't know about other people, but we are really curious to know already because Sony Spider-Man and Marvel Cinematic Universe seems to be colliding, and though we are all up for it, we still would want to know how and why exactly the characters are swapping universes. Also, once you see the trailer, you will somehow feel bad for Morbius because, for the most part of the movie, he is portrayed as the good guy who got caught up in some bad things, so Morbius basically is the hero of this movie. Yes, you heard it right. This trailer not only gives a deeper insight into the monstrous nature of Morbius, but it also paints him as a simple, intellectual, and caring human who just wants to be cured of the lethal disease. The trailer also shows a dark humor side of this movie, and Morbius's dialogue is the walking, talking proof of how dark humor is part of his character. When a colleague tells him to see a doctor for his illness, he responds with,
"I am a doctor."
And this response at the time of such great illness truly was dark and deep, saying a lot about Morbius's character. In another scene of the trailer, we are taken to the flashback in which Morbius is walking with two canes, just like he does in the present, which shows that all these years, his condition has stayed the same and he hasn't recovered even a bit, despite all the modern medicine and modern science. But it is apparent from the childhood scene that Morbius is going through the disease for a much longer time, which is not the case with the comics. The Morbius comics tell us a different story, as in the comics, Morbius gets the illness when he is in his teens. Also, because he has been sick with a lethal disease since childhood, it has affected his overall character as well, and he has spent a very difficult life. This part of the trailer really makes us sympathize with this beast, and the trailer has done a great job in capturing the essence of the movie. Other than the disease, Morbius was also bullied in school, which is perfectly showcased in a scene from the trailer. But he does find a person who comforts him, and it apparently was Nikos, who plays the character of the Morbius mentor, so it means that they are pretty close. Martin is the first supporting character revealed in the movie. Martin is not only a doctor, but we will also realize that Morbius and Martin have a love affair, which adds some twist to the movie. She also tries to figure out his disease, and in one scene, she is seen inspecting his spine. Also, when Morbius received the Nobel Prize, everyone was pretty shocked, but in this trailer, you will see that Morbius is doing a lot of charity work and is taking care of children who are going through terminal diseases. In one of the scenes of the trailer, Morbius is seen taking care of a patient named Anna, and he sees himself in her because she plays chess just like he used to play in his childhood. Anna also inspires Morbius to work harder in finding the cure, hence the bat experiment. In a romantic and beautiful scene, Morbius is taking care of Anna, and Martine is looking at him from a distance with all the love and affection of the world on her face. This scene shows us that Martine really loves his kindness and the way he takes care of people. But this would be a great plot twist because he goes on to become a bloodthirsty beast. The graphics in the trailer are also breathtakingly gothic, shady, and dark, which definitely sets the complete mood of the movie. So tell us in the comment section, what are your thoughts on the trailer? Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel. We will see you in the next video, but until then, hasta la vista!